Everyone, welcome back to another session of Computer Science Paper 2. Myself, Mijyoti Krishna from Technical Department, New English High School and Junior College. Chapter number 5, Networking Technology, Session 3. Before starting the Session 3, let us very fast revise what we have done in Session 1 and Session 2. We started with computer networking, then we have seen different type of networking, that is LAN, WAN, MAN, networking topology, types of topology, bus, ring and star topology. Then we have seen transmission media, classification of transmission media, characteristics of transmission media, and we have dealt very in detail the characteristics of transmission media. Let us proceed. Let us begin with wired media. Wired media, we know very well that wired media have a cable where the data between the nodes is carried out using cables. We have lot of wired technologies. The most popular wired media are twisted pair cable, coaxial cable and fiber optics. The least expensive and most widely used guided transmission media is twisted pair cable. The twisted pair cable consists of two wires of conducting material like copper and insulated from each other by a plastic and twisted together in a helical form. This shape is called as a helical form. So there are two copper wires here. Solid copper wire or solid copper conductor is shown, and the insulator, the outer covering of the copper wire, the insulator or PVC, is made up of plastic material, and these two copper wire are being twisted in the form of helical to form a helical shape. Okay, so this is a schematic of a twisted pair cable. It consists of two or more strands of copper wire twisted together. Here a solid copper wire is shown, but it may have number of thin copper wires bundled together, that is nothing but strands in technical term, stranded copper wire. So let us see the actual picture of the twisted pair cable. Here there are four pair of twisted pair cable. They are twisted together, two copper wires are twisted together, and it has a insulation over it made up of plastic. Since the wire are very close to each other, there is an interference of one to another wire known as crosstalk. In order to reduce the amount of crosstalk and reduce the external EMI, the wire are twisted. Why we twist the wire? Why we can't carry them straight? We twist them to avoid crosstalk and interference, electromagnetic interference. Because of twist, it generates a magnetic field and that cancels the electromagnetic effect. The most common guided transmission media for both analog and digital signal is twisted pair cable. It is the most commonly used medium in telephone network. The twisted pair cable can be divided into two categories, unshielded twisted pair and shielded twisted pair. So we'll see this now in detail. Let us see the advantages of twisted pair cable. This medium is inexpensive and easy to install. Very less material is required. Twisted wires are also reduces the crosstalk. Since the wire are twisted, it reduces the EMI and also avoid radio frequency, that is RF radiation. Now let us see the disadvantages of twisted pair cable. So they can be used only for short distance communication like in LAN. Okay, attenuation is very high. The signal gets weakened as the distance increases. It offers very poor security and is relatively easy to tap because the copper wire or the conductor is just insulated by a plastic jacket. Then applications of twisted pair cable, as said earlier, in telephone lines to carry voice and data channel. This cable is used to connect a PC to either hub in local loop. So we'll see hub in the later lectures. Unshielded twisted pair cable or UTP. UTP consists of number of twisted pair with the plastic jacket. This plastic jacket or outer jacket protect the copper wire from physical damage. Then the twist. The twisted pair protects the signal from interference. Now there are four pair are labeled as pair 1, pair 2, pair 3 and pair 4, and different color codes are used plastic insulation. So pair 2 and pair 3 are used for normal 10/100 megabits per second, and while pair 1 and pair 4 are reversed in gigabytes Ethernet, all the four are used. It is commonly used in telephone system, and nowadays UTP cables is being used in LAN. Now let us see the characteristics of UTP. The cost. The UTP cables are cheaper than any other cables. The equipment required are also low cost. Installation. UTP cable is easy to install. The UTP system can be easily reconfigured. Capacity. The data rate capacity up to 100 megabytes per second, and the cable runs to 100 meters. Attenuation. Attenuation is more as that of other copper cable, and the length of the cable is restricted to few hundred meters. EMI, that is electromagnetic interference. The UTP cable does not have shield, it just have a plastic insulation and therefore more sensitive to EMI. EMI using latest technology, the noise can be reduced. Student, I have given in a tabulated form the characteristics of UTP and other remaining cables so that it's easily to compare. When distinguish between comes, so you can easily compare on this basis, that is cost, installation, capacity, attenuation and EMI. Shielded twisted pair cable or STP. The shielded twisted pair cable consists of one or more twisted pair cables enclosed in a foil wrapped and woven copper shielding. The shield is connected to the ground portion of the electronic device to which the cable is connected. The ground portion is at electrical reference point, that is reference 0. Okay, a properly grounded shield prevents the signal from getting into or out of the cable. And lastly, it is covered by a plastic jacket. Let's see the characteristics of STP. Cost, first cost. The STP cable is more costly than coaxial or UTP. Its cost is less than thick coaxial cable or fiber optics. As per the network, different connectors are used. Installation. The installation requires skilled person, depend upon the type of network. Capacity. The data rate capacity is up to 155 megabits per second, and cable runs to 100 meter. Attenuation is less and limits the cable length up to 100 meter. Why attenuation is less? Because it is shielded. EMI is reduced due to shielding. The shield in STP results in good EMI characteristics. The STP cables have low sensitivity towards the electromagnetic interference. Let us see the second wire media, that is coaxial cable. Student, in your house, the setup box, the cable attached to the setup box is nothing but coaxial cable. So this is a diagram of coaxial cable, and in the coaxial cable there are two conductors sharing a common axis. This is the inner conductor and this is the outer conductor. They are sharing a common axis. The component of the coaxial cable are: a center conductor is a solid copper wire or a standard copper wire. The outer conductor forms the tube surrounding the inner conductor. This conductor is made up of braided wire, metallic foil, or both. The outer conductor is called as shield. This serves as a ground and protect the inner conductor from EMI. An insulator layer keeps the outer conductor spaced evenly from inner conductor. So it acts as a bridge between outer conductor and inner conductor. Then the plastic jacket. The plastic jacket protects the cable from damage. There are two type of coaxial cable: thin net and thick net. Thin net is baseband coaxial cable and thick net is a broadband coaxial cable. Thin net is thin, flexible and inexpensive. Thick net is thick, hard and expensive. Let us see very fast the advantages of coaxial cable. It provides better immunity than twisted pair. This cable is able to transmit the data at higher rate and at longer distance because it is shielded. Its shielding provides better resistance to electromagnetic interference. Attenuation is less than the twisted pair cable. Why? Because it is shielded by an outer conductor. Then disadvantages of coaxial cable: relatively more expensive than the twisted pair cable but less than the fiber optics cable. The bandwidth required capacity is less than fiber optics cable. Application of coaxial cable: used in analog telephone network, digital telephone network and cable TV. The third wired media is fiber optics cable. It is designed to transmit the light wave. A light wave can be efficiently conducted through the transparent glass fiber cable. The communication is carried out by the fiber optics cable using a light wave. The light source is known as fiber optic communication. The fiber optic cable is used in optical transmission system. Now let us see the construction of fiber optics cable. The center conductor, see, this is a center conductor or the core of this cable is fiber that consists of highly refined glass or plastic. Transmit lies with less loss. The fiber is coated with a cladding that reflects the signal back, that is total internal reflection into the fiber to reduce signal loss. And this hole is protected. Plastic sheet protects the fiber from damage. Now let us see the characteristics of the fiber optics cost. The cost is more than the coaxial cable and twisted pair cable. Now installation. The required skilled installation. Every cable has a minimum band radius. They may get damaged if bent sharply. Fiber optics cannot be stretched. So we require a skilled person for installation. Then capacity. Supports high data rate up to 2 gigabits per second even with a long run cable. This cable have extremely high bandwidth. Then attenuation.
The attenuation is much less than coaxial cable and twisted pair cable. Then electromagnetic interference. This cable has no sensitivity to EMI. It has zero sensitivity to EMI and can run over several kilometers. Fiber optics cable does not use electrical data. Therefore, they are free from EMI. The data transfer in fiber optics have high security as it cannot be detected by the electronic wave topping equipment. So, it is highly secured. Let us see the comparison between the wired media. There are coaxial cable, twisted pair cable and fiber optics cable based on their properties like cost, installation, attenuation, EMI effect, bandwidth and signal type. Cost. Coaxial cable are inexpensive. The cost more than coaxial cable, that of the shielded twisted pair cable, and it is expensive because it is using a lightweight. Installation easy, required skilled person. Attenuation more but less than twisted cable, more than in case of UTP than in STP, and very less because it is using the light wave and not the electrical signal. EMI effect maximum but less than twisted pair cable, maximum in case of UTP because there is no shielding, no effect. The bandwidth 1 to 100 megabits per second and 100 meter, 1 to 500 megabits per second and 100 meter, up to 2 gigabits per second. The signal type that can be transmitted: electromagnetic, analog and digital, electrical, electromagnetic, analog and digital, and light signal. So in exam the comparison comes between any two the wired media, either coaxial cable, twisted pair. So you can just write based on that properties. After completing wired media, let us see wireless media in detail. They are radio wave, microwave, infrared wave and laser wave. Waves. The radio waves have the frequency between 3 GHz to 1 GHz. 1 GHz. The radio waves are omnidirectional. What do you mean by omnidirectional? They travel in all directions from the source. Because of this property, the transmitter and the receiver need not be aligned. They should not be in one line. The radio wave can penetrate building easily. They are widely used for both indoor and outdoor communication. Different frequency ranges can be used for radio communication. As the radio wave covers a long distance, interference between the user is a problem. So there is the interference between the two users may be a problem. So for this reason, government license is necessary to transmit the radio wave. You have to take the license for transmitting the, in which band you are transmitting the radio wave. So for that, you have to take the government license. So there is no interference. Radio communication have the major drawback that it may be disturbed by the brain, or they are absorbed by the rain. For it offers low bandwidth for a data communication. That is a drawback. And the radio wave are widely used in FM radio, television, cellular phone and wireless LAN. Microwaves. The microwaves are electromagnetic waves having frequency between 1 GHz to 300 GHz. Microwave are unidirectional. Unlike radio wave, they are unidirectional. Therefore, the repeaters are required to strengthen the signals. The microwave requires line of sight propagation as they travel only in straight line from the source. So, for the antenna should be in the line of sight. The microwave are not able to penetrate into walls. That is a drawback. It cannot penetrate through the walls. The distance covered by the line of sight depends on the large extent of the height of the antenna. So, height of the antenna is the issue now, because distance covered depends on the height of the antenna. It is widely used for one-to-one communication, cellular phone, and satellite network. Infrared waves or millimeter wave. Electromagnetic wave having frequency from 300 GHz to 400 terahertz are called IR or infrared waves. Infrared waves are used for short range communication and used line of sight propagation. So the receiver and the sender and the receiver should be in the line of sight. Infrared wave cannot pass through solid object. Unlike the microwave, they also cannot pass through solid object. They are cheap, easy to build, and do not require any government license to use them. The IR offer very large bandwidth. Then the best example of IR wave is your TV remote control. Okay. The last wireless media is laser. This type of transmission uses the laser beam to transfer the data up to few kilometers. The laser beam are unidirectional. They also travel in a straight line from the source. Such a system offer very high bandwidth at very low cost. Thus, this type of transmission system uses line of sight propagation. Therefore, the source and the destination should be the line of sight. The laser can be used for LAN and WAN transmission. Laser cannot transmit through a thick fog. On hot sunny day, these waves are affected by the hot turbulent. Let us summarize what we have seen in today's session. We have seen wired media. So there are three types of wired media: twisted pair cable, coaxial pair cable, and fiber optics. We have seen in detail. Then we have seen wireless media. That is radio wave, microwave, infrared wave, and laser in detail. So we came here to the end of the networking technology session 3.19.